Yes, now you have got the knowledge how to join the words, isn't it? If I say, for example, senior, now they have given, I feel sad. Means if you feel sad, what your friend will say? I will tell you the joke, no, don't be sad, I won't be look good. So I will tell you a joke, then you will be feel happy. So our friends will give suggestions, isn't it? Now, for example, if I get fever, I am feeling very heavy fever, otherwise I am feeling very heavy stomach ache. So what my friend will tell me? Why can't you visit the doctor? So she is giving the suggestion to me. In that way, yesterday in the previous class we have discussed the speaking, isn't it? Yes. Now in this today's class we are going to discuss using the language in page number 32. Okay, before going to the class now. We have heard so many lessons here, isn't it? Unit 1, Unit 2, we have completed. In Unit 1 and in Unit 2, what you have observed, even in Unit 3, we have completed the story. What you have observed in the story, study? You can tell me now. Did you get it? No. What? Nothing you have observed in the lessons, huh? Yes. See here, no need to worry. In the lessons, after completing the each sentence, there will be a full stop. Have you observed the? What's the symbol of full stop? Yes, see here. After completing the each sentence. Now, example, Robin Sam Tracy had built a house on island. After completing the island, there is a full stop here. Isn't it? Have you observed? Open the books and observe now. Yes, it is there in all the lessons. Even not only the even for in maths, otherwise in Telugu, Hindi, in all the languages, in all the subjects, there will be a punctuation marks here. So first we have completed the full stop. And when we use comma here, when we have completed half sentence and remaining half we still we did not complete. So then we are keeping the comma. Example here for the comma now. I want to go school, but I am feeling headache. I want to go school, but I am feeling headache. So now we have completed the full sentence here, and in the end of the sentence, we have put a full stop. Now, one more example. What is the one more example? There are so many fruits. There are so many fruits. So there are so many fruits, okay. But what happened there? Fruits are there, but what happened there? We don't know. So that is not the complete sentence. So the sentence which did not complete, which doesn't complete the full word, that is in the words we keep a comma here. For the full stop, after completing all the sentence, after completing all the explanation, we put a full stop. Even in our question and answers also, we put a full stop. Where we will keep the full stop? In the middle of the lesson, in the middle of the answer, na? No, after ending, after completing all the answers, we put a, we will put a full stop. And after completing each sentence, there will be a full stop. For incomplete sentence, there will be a comma. So we have studied about comma and we have studied about full stop. What about the question mark? Where we use the question mark? Tell me. What is your name? What is your name? I am asking you a question. Whenever you are in the school, teachers all the times will ask you the questions, isn't it? Yes, where are you going? What you are eating? What you are drinking? Where you are going? Why you are doing like this? Why you are doing like that? So teachers normally use so many questions in our school time, isn't it? Yes. So whenever the person is asking you a question, at the end of the question, there will be a question mark. See, this is a question mark. So now you know the full stop and comma and question mark. So today we are going to discuss about the apostrophe. So apostrophe, where you see here, comma is down, full stop is also down. But here apostrophe will be the upside. Okay. Where it will be? It will be the upwards. The apostrophe will put Robinson's ship sank. That is a monocycle. That is monocycle. Is it a proper sentence? No. It is a monocycle. Means the cycle belongs to the mona. And these fruits are, now example, now in plural we shall see, these are the fruits from which the Rohit got milk. These are the fruits. So in the fruits, where we are keeping apostrophe? After completing fruits spelling, we will put the apostrophe. We shall see in singular and we shall see in the plural. Singular. Mohit's book. See here now in the singular. Mohit's book. Where we are keeping the apostrophe in singular? Mohit book. Is it a proper sentence? When another person is saying to someone, this book is Mohit book. Do we say this? No. This is a Mohit's book. Means the book belongs to the Mohit. So after completing Mohit, we put the apostrophe mark here and we write here S. S is must here. Apostrophe and S in a singular. Mohit book is a wrong sentence. Mohit's book is a right sentence. See here, Mohit is the name of the boy and apostrophe and S, book. Now second one, Rohan's bicycle. This is a, tell me, this is a Rohan's bicycle. This is a Rohan bicycle. Is it a proper sentence? No, na. So Rohan is a name of the boy and apostrophe and S are added to them. Belongs to the Rohan here. Okay, have you got it? Whenever we are heading, for example, now this gesture is, this gesture is belong to teacher. Is it a right one? Otherwise, this gesture is, this is a Mona Duster. This is a Mona Duster. Mona Duster. Is it a right one? No. Then what we have to add? Mona's duster, Mona's bottle, Mona's pencil, Mona's book. So in this way, whenever in the singular form after completing the name, we are adding apostrophe and S to show what? To show that the book belongs to the Rohan or Mohan, whatever the names are there. Now in the plural form, boys' school. The school only belongs to the one boy? No. One girl? No. Boys. So here see the difference. Boy is a singular. Boy is a singular. When we are adding S to that, it becomes to, it changes to plural. So in plural, we have to put the apostrophe after the S. Here before the S, we have put in singular. And after the S, we are keeping in plural. Boys, school. Ladies, hospital. Do the hospital belong to only one lady here? No. Ladies, hospital. So after the S, we are putting a apostrophe. After the S, we are putting a apostrophe. In the singular, before the S, we are keeping a apostrophe. Now see here some more examples. Mohit's book. My friend's mother. My friend mother. Is it a proper sentence? No, no. My friend mother. This is a wrong one. How we have to say my friend's mother? Means the mother belongs to your friend. She is a mother of your friend. Now, Rohan's bicycle. Rohan's bicycle. Rohan bicycle. So both are in singular. So that is not a right sentence, that is not a proper sentence. So whenever we are adding apostrophe and S, then it shows that the bicycle belongs to the Rohan. Now in plural, boys' school, ladies' hospital, ladies' hostel, boys' hostel, isn't it? Here so many words we can match in singular or plural. Names ending in S. Thomas Petrigo. In Thomas. Thomas means what? T-H-O-M-A-S. So the word, the name is ending with Yes, with S letter. So, where we have to put the apostrophe here? Just now I explained it. In plural form, where we have to put the S? After, sorry, where we have to put the apostrophe? After the S. First you have to write S and then we have to put the apostrophe. But in the singular, first we have to put the apostrophe mark and then we have to write the S. Normally in singular words, there will be a no S. Note, in modern usage, there is usually no S after the apostrophe for names ending in S, for example. So here, in the modern there is no S. So first there will be only a apostrophe mark, there will be a no S here. So now that is what we are using, S we are using and as well as we are using a apostrophe mark. Okay, have you understood? See, once again I will explain you. First, what is the full stop here? After completing each sentence, we put a full stop. After completing the sentence, complete of sentence, we use a full stop. Incomplete of sentence, we use comma. And whenever the teacher is asking you a question, there will be a question mark. So today in this class, we have learned apostrophe, isn't it? Well, in apostrophe, where we will use apostrophe and why we are using apostrophe? Yes, because to show the possessive form, means what is going to happen. This is, for example, this is someone will tell, this book is mine. This book is mine. Then you will say, no, this is my friend's book. This is my friend's book is not a correct one. How you have to say, this is my friend's book. So in the plural, in the singular form, see here, in the singular form, first there will be a apostrophe mark and after that there will be a S. Normally in the plural, in the singular form, do we add S there? No. So, Mohit's book. So, apostrophe is must here, okay? If you keep apostrophe, then only the sentence will be the correct one. If you won't keep apostrophe and you will say Mohit's book, means that the sentence will be a wrong sentence. Mohit's book. Mohit book. Book is also a singular and Mohit is also a noun. So, now nouns are there. So, without the confusion, to show that the book belongs to whom, we are using Mohit's book. So, the book is belongs to the Mohit. Now, Rohan's bicycle. Rohan bicycle. So, this is also a not a correct sentence. Rohan's bicycle. First apostrophe mark and then after the apostrophe we are adding S in singular. In the plural, after adding the S, we are adding apostrophe. Here, first apostrophe mark and the second is S. But in the plural, S is the first and apostrophe is the second part. Okay. In this way, we have completed the using apostrophe. How we are going to use apostrophe mark? They have given a bit to us. In the next class, we shall discuss what is the bit that